Awesome. Thank you so much for that introduction. That was wonderful. I appreciate everyone hopping on here today. I hope everyone's having a good Wednesday afternoon so far. We'll go ahead and get the ball rolling. Hopefully, everyone can see my screen okay. But my name is Amber Holden, and I'm one of the directors of education here at Abyde. And as she just mentioned, Abyde is DrChrono's preferred HIPAA compliance partner, and we are super honored to be chosen as the vehicle to carry out today's message on behalf of DrChrono. I will tell you a little bit more about who we are at Abyde as we go forward in the next few slides. But again, guys, we appreciate you carving out some time today and joining us. And as you can see by the title of the webinar, today we're going to be talking about the first and perhaps the most important step in achieving a complete HIPAA compliance program, which is the security risk analysis. And we've been doing webinars for DrChrono users since we became partners with them. So the response has been tremendous, and I expect for all of you to have that same experience here as well. So as I mentioned, again, my name is Amber Holden, and just going to highlight that Abyde is focused on exponential education and HIPAA resources. So if you guys have any questions that I can help you with regarding HIPAA, or any of the content that we're going to cover, please don't hesitate to reach out to me directly. You can also chat in the chat feature here as well if you do have some questions. My contact information will be popping up here at the end also. So taking a quick step back, just to tell you briefly about who we are here at Abyde and where we come in. So we are a technology company based out of sunny Tampa, Florida. We're the industry leaders when it comes to HIPAA compliance, and we provide education and solutions specifically for the eye care industry. So this is one of the many reasons why DrChrono is so excited about our partnership. On that note, we're going to go ahead and begin to simplify the HIPAA security risk analysis for you guys here today. So here at Abyde, we like to think of a complete HIPAA compliance program like a puzzle. So you're pretty much looking at this through more of like an auditor's lens. Each piece coming together plays an essential part in protecting your patients and your practice. So now, as you can see, these pieces or requirements are broken down by the HIPAA security rule and the privacy rule as well. And while not one standard is more important than the other, but the very first piece of completing the bigger HIPAA puzzle is the focus of today's webinar, which is that security risk analysis. So now many of you have probably heard of this requirement before and may actually be completing some of it on your own, but let's define what the HIPAA security risk analysis or SRA is for what it actually is. So HIPAA law defines the security risk analysis as an accurate and thorough assessment of the potential risks and vulnerabilities to the confidentiality, integrity, and availability of electronically protected health information held by the covered entity or business associate. So really in layman's terms, this is going to be a self-evaluation of your practices, processes, and policies to shed light on any potential risks and vulnerabilities in protecting the privacy and security of your practice and the protected health information that it holds. Now, it's important to understand, are you guys able to see my screen okay? Anyone wants to let me know, goes black on my end.
Yeah, it went dark.
Yeah, I'm not sure what happened there. I apologize. We're having some technical difficulties. All right, is it back up for you guys?
It's back up now, Amber.
Okay, awesome. Thank you. All right, going back to where I left off. So now it's important to understand that if you don't have this first piece of the puzzle, you and the government can't really move any further with the rest of your HIPAA puzzle, quote unquote. The risk analysis is a requirement for all covered entities under the HIPAA security rule, and it's going to be the first step to assessing any potential risks and vulnerabilities to protected health information held by your organization. So again, this is a self-evaluation of your practice, assesses three categories of safeguards, which are the administrative, the physical, and the technical safeguards. They want you to evaluate these safeguards that you have in place, which is usually fairly easy to identify. But the problem lies with identifying those safeguards that you don't have in place. And that's where the government wants you to implement solutions to mitigate any vulnerable areas within your practice. So obviously, I know we probably have some doctors, maybe some office managers here on today. For the eye care practices, it could be hard to know what safeguards you need and currently don't have. If you knew about them, you probably would have already implemented a solution or a plan to implement them. So with you being an office manager, a doctor, you're doing a million other things each day. So how are you supposed to know on your own what's considered best HIPAA practices for an eye care provider? So that's really where it starts to present a problem to the small and mid-sized practice environment, because you're not HIPAA experts. You know, a lot of the times you don't have the time or the energy to make sure it is getting done accurately or thoroughly enough, but it does need to get done one way or another. It is still required a minimum once per year. So with all HIPAA requirements being essential for your organization to complete, why is the security risk analysis so important, yet so often missed? So for starters, this is what auditors are going to ask for in all situations first, if audited. Knock on wood, that never happens, but it's essential it is documented for the practice. So they're not going to come to your office and see how your day-to-day operations go. They are going to ask for proof of the security risk analysis. Also, the security risk analysis works in helping to secure PHI, protected health information, which is something that is vital to your organization, but it can be a tad complex at times, which is why we always recommend getting expert assistance. However, you can see the widespread lack of completing this requirement has been the cause of many failed audits and has resulted in over $65 million being returned to the government from MU participants. But don't let the non-compliance number fool you. Many practices think that just they are fulfilling this requirement, but they're actually missing the mark a bit. And the reason for that is largely due to all of the widespread confusion when it comes to your security risk analysis. So we're gonna discuss a few of the common myths that we hear when it comes to the SRA. So the first misconception we hear all too often is, as long as I complete the security risk analysis once, I'm good to go. So as stated explicitly in the HIPAA security rule, risk analysis should be an ongoing process in which a covered entity regularly reviews its records to track access to EPHI, and detect security incidents, periodically evaluates the effectiveness of the security measures put in place, and regularly reevaluates potential risks to PHI. Also, another commonly heard myth that we hear is, my EHR system takes care of the privacy and security of my data, so I don't need to worry about the SRA. So in truth, your electronic health record system doesn't actually conduct a risk analysis for you. So though EHR vendors can help you use their product, they aren't responsible for the privacy and the security compliance. So additionally, an SRA involves all PHI at your organization, including data that isn't housed on your EHR, like paper records and files. The third misconception that we hear is, many organizations think that their IT company handles a full SRA. So similar to the confusion around your organization's EHR, IT companies might help assess technical safeguards and identify potential technical risks, but it does not provide a comprehensive analysis of all aspects of your organization, like your administrative and your physical areas that need to be addressed as well. All right, number four, another myth that we hear is, I'm a small practice, so I don't need to conduct an SRA. So regardless of the size or the specialty, all healthcare providers who are covered entities under HIPAA are obligated to perform a risk analysis each year. And the last misconception is that a simple templated checklist can cut it to fulfill the SRA requirement. So while checklists can be helpful tools and the OCR does provide specific guidance, in order for your security risk analysis to be complete, it does need to assess specific elements of your organization and practice operations, which may differ from the types of things that are just assessed in a template or generic checklist that they may give you. All right, so now that you know what the SRA is and why it's super important, and also what misconceptions you should avoid, let's go ahead and just jump into exactly what a complete security risk analysis should include. So ultimately, your SRA should identify where PHI is stored and how it's received or transmitted for the full scope of your practice. This includes accounting for all areas of your electronic medical record systems to your patient billing systems. It also must assess current security measures used to safeguard PHI. Next, it should assess whether the current security measures are used properly, which is super important. Additionally, it must determine the potential impact of a breach of PHI. Next slide is going to continue here as well. It also should assign risk levels for vulnerability and impact combinations. It should identify and document potential threats and vulnerabilities. And finally, it should provide action steps to help address and mitigate risks wherever necessary. Alrighty, and as I mentioned a few slides back, the purpose of a security risk analysis is to assess all aspects of your organization and evaluate the safeguards that you have in place. So the first type of safeguard is administrative. These safeguards focus your organization's internal policies, procedures, and maintenance of security measures that protect patients' health information. As you can see here, the types of questions that are asked to assess the safeguard highlight just certain policies and procedures like personal email access within your practice. Next, we have the technical safeguard. So in addition to the administrative, the second type here is that technical safeguard. And according to its definition in HIPAA law, this covers technology and the policies and procedures for its use to protect EPHI, so electronic healthcare information, and control access to that also. So assessing your technical safeguards include looking at things like unique logins for computers and other security measures that are used to protect the IT systems within your organization. All right, and lastly, we have those physical safeguards. So HIPAA law defines these physical policies and procedures to protect a covered entity's electronic information systems and related buildings and equipment from natural and environmental hazards or any unauthorized intrusions you may have. Properly assessing these safeguards involve looking at things that are a bit more, well, physical. This includes asking questions like there's locks on the practice's door and safe storage of PHI and EPHI. So in addition to addressing all the necessary safeguards, what other boxes do you need to check in order to fully complete the SRA requirement? So as I mentioned before, the assessment must be comprehensive and complete. So this means looking at each of the three safeguards, assessing risk levels and assigning risk levels, and providing mitigation steps for addressing any vulnerabilities that you found. So another thing that I mentioned a few slides back was that the security risk analysis is certainly not just one and done type of requirement. Fulfilling HIPAA standards means continually updating the assessment annually as well as on an ongoing basis to keep up with legislative updates and operational changes within your organization. And last but certainly not least, proper documentation is essential to actually prove your practice's efforts in completing this assessment as well. So with all that in mind, remember that puzzle analogy that I started us off with. Well, we're bringing it full circle here. The SRA requirement that we just spent the last few minutes discussing is only one piece of your full HIPAA compliance program, but it does play an essential role in just laying the foundation for all the other steps in compliance. So qualifying for a HIPAA safe harbor incentives and avoiding a HIPAA fine means having all of those puzzle pieces in place. And before you think, well, if that many other practices are missing the requirement, then will the government really come after my small practice? Well, there's plenty of reasons, including a recently passed government incentive for practices that have the necessary safeguards in place to protect their practice and patients. So the Safe Harbor Law was passed earlier this year, and it is a huge step taken in the right direction for covered entities to protect themselves from HIPAA fines. So it may not sound like earth-shattering information for some, but under the HIPAA Safe Harbor Law, the government has enacted the bipartisan bill just to encourage covered entities to implement HIPAA standards that meet federal and state laws. So this is really just stating that there's going to be reduced penalties for those who are compliant should there ever be a HIPAA incident like a data breach or a patient complaint. Great news is here, if your practice can show compliance within these aspects for at least 12 months prior to any HIPAA incident like a breach, complaint, proactive audit, whatever it may be, then the Office of Civil Rights will reduce fines, they'll cut short any HIPAA audits, or reduce the corrective action plan, hopefully all three, that your practice may have otherwise received. So now, not to sound like a broken record here, but the security risk analysis is just one of many requirements your organization needs to have completed annually. And as I mentioned, HIPAA law entities need to have each requirement to complete the annual deadline, which is coming up pretty quickly. It's approaching on us very fast, December 31st. So you're probably wondering, where do you start? So when it comes to checking off your security risk analysis at the end of the year to-do list, meeting those annual HIPAA requirements, your organization must have a complete and comprehensive security risk analysis for 2021. All right, so this means having an analysis that covers everything that I just harped on throughout the webinar today, all properly documented and specific to your organization's compliance environment. So next, you must continue to mitigate risk within the administrative, the technical, and the physical safeguards within your organization, properly assessing all three safeguards, as well as assigning risk levels and impact levels, help shed light on what gaps are in your current compliance efforts. And the mitigation measures needed to fill them as well. And finally, you must continually assess and update your security risk analysis documentation on an ongoing basis. All right, but while one thing to know what needs to be done is just, it's another to actually do it, right? So here are some approaches practices have used to conduct a complete SRA. So first thing practices have done is hiring a third-party consultant. So none of you on this call are expected to be HIPAA experts in addition to all the many hats that you guys wear on a day-to-day basis. So having a professional help in assessing your organization's environment provides perspective and expertise that might have been otherwise missed. However, the downside of this is that it can be extremely costly and time-consuming hiring a third party. But the second approach here is utilizing the government tool. So we mentioned this tool and other available resources that the government provides back in our misconception slide. But as a refresher, since there isn't, you know, a one-size-fits-all analysis, these tools and templates often leave gaps in covering the full scope of your organization. And third, last but not least, this approach is doing it yourself. So while it is, of course, possible for a practice to implement and maintain a comprehensive security risk analysis and complete HIPAA program themselves, let's face it, a lot of practices just don't have the time, especially nowadays. All the things that we've covered so far today are just one of the several requirements a practice is expected to understand, address, document, and continually update. And in fact, we actually estimate it does take an average about 80 hours for a practice to manage HIPAA on their own. Now, I know that was a lot of information, but before you go into panic mode, you don't have to do this alone. So for the last couple minutes here, we are going to just spend a little time talking about how we can help you check off all those items on your to-do list in the easiest way possible. So Abyde is designed to not just give your practice a complete HIPAA program with continuous updates on recent changes we just covered, but with the addition to the benefit of a dream team of HIPAA experts to support you every step of the way. All the complexities of HIPAA have been simplified into one easy to use software, so smooth. It's like hitting the easy button on HIPAA. So in fact, a lot of eye care practices think of us as like TurboTax for HIPAA. Definitely don't have to be an expert to manage it at all. And with Abyde, every customer receives a complete HIPAA emergency protection. So our goal here is to make sure you don't have any of those oh no situations, but there are situations that you are prepared for and feel good about in the long run. So it is true with Abyde, your practice can never stress about HIPAA again. I'm gonna switch my screen here just to show you a quick little test drive on what it's like firsthand. All righty. I'll go ahead and log in here. So Abyde, oh no. Hold on guys, another technical difficulties. There we go. So Abyde is an incredible solution that allows thousands of medical practices across the country just easily implement and sustain a HIPAA compliance program that meets all of the requirements. So again, like I said before, think of it as TurboTax for HIPAA. We do have a notification system, which is really the backbone of Abyde. This is how we communicate with you on a regular basis and do objectives. And we'll tell you what to do, when to do it, how to do it. Best part is everything is completely automated, so you're not drafting or editing any documentation. But as you fill out your profile information and you complete that security risk analysis that we were talking about today, we'll go ahead and just generate policies and procedures that are specific to your practice. So I'm sure you can see why eye care practices love it. Little to $3 a day, only spending 5 to 15 minutes a month, you'll have peace of mind that you'll pass a HIPAA audit. I'll go ahead and switch my screen back here. All right, and as a DrChrono user, you already received 10% discount, but as an extra little thank you for everyone hopping on here today, we are gonna double that offer to an exclusive promo code for 20% off, or at least 3 months completely free with that discount. You can just use the promo code here that you see on your screen. You can sign up with that special discount just as a thank you to us for taking some time just to learn why HIPAA is so important and why this requirement is so important. If you do want to learn more about how to use Abyde for your practice and implement and maintain your HIPAA program, you can see why DrChrono has chosen us as their preferred HIPAA compliance partner. You're more than welcome to schedule a one-on-one demo of our solution using the link or the QR code that you see on your screen here as well. I'll leave that there for just a second. We'll dive into some questions if you guys have any. You can use that chat feature or you can unmute yourself if you like. So we will wrap it up today. If you guys have any questions, now's the time to ask.
All right, perfect. And there is a question here that, I did have a question. The question here is, how long does it take to complete the security risk analysis if I decide to purchase Abyde?
Yeah, no, great question. So typically it takes from anywhere from 30 to 40 hours for a practice to complete on their own, whether they're using the government tool or trying to do it themselves. Using our automated security risk analysis, it's going to be about 75 to 100 questions. It's going to take you about 30 to 45 minutes to complete. So it's definitely not going to take up too much of your time. It's not going to be a hassle. It's definitely not going to be 30 to 40 hours to get the security risk analysis completed using Abyde. I hope that answers your question.
Yes. And another question came in. What is the annual price? And I'm assuming that's for the package that you guys offer.
Yeah, so our software, it's going to be an annual subscription. It's a cross matrix between locations and employees. So it depends on how many locations you have, how many employees you have. However, it is as little as $3 a day when it comes to using our solution. And again, you guys get that 20% discount for joining us today. If you do want a more in-depth look on it, you're more than welcome to send me an email or give me a call and we can go over that.
Question here, someone's asking how much for one location and five employees. I'm assuming that's something they'll probably be able to tell you in more detail with the conversation, I'm sure.
Yeah, most definitely. So, Becky, if you want to send me an email or give me a call, we can go over pricing, just so it's not in front of everyone, which is not, you know, a terrible thing. But if you want to do a one-on-one conversation, we can go over everything with you.
Okay. Let's see. Oh, they didn't hear the annual price. The connection was weak. Just wanted to confirm with the annual
price. Okay. Sure. So yeah, just to reiterate, annual pricing, it depends on locations and employees for your practice. Again, it's as little as $3 a day. If you use that QR code, you can get that 20% discount for your annual subscription. If you do end up signing up, you'll be locked in with the 20% after renewal as well.
Okay, another question here, just talking about how, is there any like software or any type of tools that would need to be, installed on their system in order to use your product? What about policies and things like
that? Great question. Yeah. So Abyde is cloud-based, so there's not going to be any downloading the software or integrating it with your EHR or anything like that. So it is cloud-based. You just need your login. This can be accessed anywhere, whether it's from your smartphone, an iPad, your computer. If you want to, you know, be at home drinking a glass of wine, completing your security risk analysis, so you're able to. But there's no downloading the solution. It is cloud-based, and you can just go to abyde.com once you have your information.
And let's see. A question about just the successes of people that pick your product.
Yeah. We've had many people really enjoy our solution. We do take the stress out of managing your HIPAA compliance program. We give practices their time back. So rather than shutting the practice down for training or having an office manager spend hours and hours and hours on end completing your security risk analysis, we automate that entire process for you. And we make sure, just to make it less stressful for you guys, you have so much going on your day to day. We want to make sure that you don't have to stress about HIPAA, and that's what our solution is about. But we've had many people come to Abyde and really excel their expectations just because of how easy it is to use.
And on top of that as well, something we're very proud of, we've been through dozens and dozens of audits with our customers to date. We've never failed one, or none of our customers have ever paid a dime to the government as well.
Definitely something we take pride in for sure. Thanks for hopping in there, Wade.
All right, does anyone have any questions about the presentation, about the services? Any other questions? If not, we'll cut it short, but I just wanted to be sure everyone's questions were addressed. Anyone have any questions for the Abyde team? Okay, if there are no further questions, then we'll go ahead. Oh. However, yes, so to answer your question, you will receive this recording via email and a follow-up email that Dr. Crono will send to you. So we will follow up with you with this recording for your reference. And I would say in about a week or less, you should receive this recording for your reference.
And if anyone has any questions that they think of later on, don't hesitate to reach out to Abyde, either by phone, email, whatever it may be. But yeah, that's all I got for today. So I appreciate everyone just hopping on here and taking the time out of your Wednesday to learn more about the security risk analysis. And I really hope that you've all gained just a clear understanding of what your practice should be doing just to ensure you're protected and compliant. So I hope everyone has a great rest of their day.
Yes, and email, I'm sorry, what did you want emailed, Bobby? I'm sorry, was that the discount code?
I think she was looking for the QR code to schedule something with Amber.
Okay.
Yeah, you can email Amber too, and we can get you set up.
I put the QR code back on the screen, Bobby, if you want to take a picture of that.
Are you good now, Bobby? Just want to be sure. Don't want to close it off. Okay, cool.
Awesome.
All right. So with that being said, if there aren't any further questions, we'll go ahead and close it off. Thank you guys for your time. This recording will be on its way over, and you guys enjoy the rest of your Wednesday. Thank you, Amber, for a great presentation as well.
Thank you for having us. I appreciate it.
Thank you. All right. Bye-bye, everyone.
All right.
Have a good day.
Bye.